Hello gamers, this weekend features the historic Arena Open and I wanted to play something different other than the, you know, the usual Golgari food, Is it Phoenix, Azorius Control, Azorius Aura Scanner decks. And in the last couple of weeks I've been seeing this Celestnia Enchantress deck post some pretty decent results and I thought, well, let's give it a try. Usually on day one of the Arena Opens, I play best of one because I like that the games are going much faster. You can do stuff between the games. There's more breaks. You have more losses to give, so it's a little bit less punishing in a way. If you're well practiced in the format, I think best of three is probably a little bit more higher EV for you to enter. But I think best of one is more, you know, fun. It's faster and you get to play more games, and you know, there's also something to it. I chose this deck that I found in one of the recent tournaments. Unfortunately, I don't have the tournament open anymore, so I could give the person credit, but it's been around for a while. The most important combo of the deck is the nine lives plus Solemnity combo. If they're both in play, your opponent can't damage you anymore, which is great against, you know, decks like Is it Phoenix, or if you're playing best of one, there's going to be people playing, you know, goblins, and they're going to be playing Gruul aggro, and there's going to be a lot of creature decks. But at the same time, it doesn't really work against, you know, Meat Hoop Massacre kind of like decks that drain you with the Cannon Oven. So I'm kind of looking forward to seeing how it's gonna work out for me. Also, four Paladin class is something I would not expect in a deck like this. I'm not sure if there are just no better one mana enchantments. Like you want to play a lot of them, so you can get a lot of mana with Sanctum Beaver and, you know, trigger your triggers and everything and draw some extra cards. But it doesn't really strike me as like one of the most powerful cards I can imagine in a deck like this. Even if you could play Legion's Landing is an enchantment, you know, makes a 1/1 token with lifelink, buys you some time. I don't know, I could definitely see some other enchantments other than that, so I'm curious to see how it's gonna go. Enchantress, historic rank, best of three. No, best of one, actually, that's what I wanted to do. Best of one, Enchantress, and let's go. Yeah, I'm hoping to play against a lot of creature decks. Hopefully we're not gonna, you know, get paired against Nif-Mizzet with a bunch of Maelstrom Pulses or Blue-White Control with Farewell in the main deck and stuff like that. There's the Paladin class. And there's the downside of playing a card like Boseiju. It doesn't make this come into play tapped. Or untapped, rather. So I can't go Paladin class into something else, but I guess that's a good thing in a way. Yeah, I guess that's a good thing in a way, because I'm going to be drawing an extra card from it thanks to Sithis. We'll see how this turns out. That is Nif-Mizzet, actually. Against Nif-Mizzet, I think maybe just starting with Sterling Grove could be the right move, because then they don't kill the Sithis with a Lightning Helix or Fatal Push or something like that. Yeah, let's go with that. I guess not. I should have still started with the Willful Lowhaven probably, so I can have four mana on the next turn if I draw a land, and then I would go. I guess I would still play the Sterling though first, because I really don't want them to kill this. So that still wouldn't have worked. This is probably best. Forces them to play. Yeah, let's start with that. It forces them to play the Deafening Clarion or something like that if they have it. And if not, I'll start drawing some extra cards. Okay, that's fine. We can deal with that. So this rummages, if I remember correctly, when exhaust cards from graveyards, none of that really matters. I can take a turn off and just play Enchanter's Presence so I can start drawing more cards, but I don't think I really need that. I think I'm just really better off just dealing with this right away. Drawing a card. I mean, 5 life is not that relevant when I'm. Yeah, you know what? I'll go for the presence. I'm gonna make the greedier play, but I mean, Niv-Mizzet is not exactly a deck that's trying to kill you super fast. So, Binding. Okay, Binding's good, but they have to take the Sterling Grove out first. I can imagine that they want to get rid of something not great in the matchup. Okay, land, that works too. Sterling Grove. Well, I can take one more turn off. That's fine. So I go Willful Haven and draw to Sterling Grove. That's a lot of cards. I'm starting to like this deck. I guess I don't need to play the Sterling Grove. I can just play the Touch right now and deal with this. But then they kill my citizen. Yeah, I guess I'll go for the Sterling Grove anyway. Just drawing so many cards, I like that. Drawing cards, gaining life, no big deal. Gonna be discarding here. But that's a good problem to have. Yeah, I'll attack for one. I'll discard my Temple Garden. Gauntlets of Light. Okay. So I guess you can get infinite mana if you have a lot of enchantments. I don't know if you really need that, but it is one of the things this deck can do. Sterling Grove is doing some work this game so far. Hydroid is a 3/3. That's not super scary. Oh, wow. Yeah, okay. Whew, so I have what? 6 mana? 3, 4, 5, 6. I can play this guy. Yeah, I should probably play the Sanctum Weaver so that I start going off from next turn. Yeah, I don't think I want to put all three in play because then they kind of just die to Deafening Clarion. So keeping one in hand sounds actually pretty reasonable. I could play Jukai Natural. I have so many cards that just kind of throwing one of them away is not the worst. Even if they have the Clarion. It's not gonna be the end of the world. Touch of the Spirit Realm. Deal with the 5/5. No attacks. I'm discarding Rest in Peace. One Solemnity maybe, and I'm gonna run out of cards. Maybe I discard one of maybe I discard an Enchantress Presence and a Solemnity. Kind of a the rich get richer problem. Maybe there's some infinite hidden combo that I'm not seeing. I can go to level 3 whenever it's something attacks. Whenever something attacks, can get +1/+1, double strike for each other other creature. Well, I mean, we'll see. See what happens. Thoughtseize. Thoughtseize is good. Oh yeah, we're gonna have a lot of mana. I can make an XX elemental with double strike. Can I give it flying? Really? But yeah, let's start with the Gauntlets of Light. Should I can start with this two? Yeah, this is better. Oh no, 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 no. Let's go with Gauntlets on the weave. Oh wait, I can't target them either. Shroud is not hexproof. Oh no, Shroud is not hexproof. Okay, there goes my whole game plan. Well, I guess I can always sacrifice the Sterling Grove. Oh, I should have added mana first. That would have been better. Well, I can just search for another Sterling Grove, I guess. Okay, guys, this is my first time playing the deck, okay? Cut me some slack. A lot of mana. Let's add green. All right. Our opponent's like, yeah, this guy's probably taking a little bit too much time, but thing with all the mana from this and drawing my entire deck, I should be able to just put everything in play and activate all these paladins classes and everything. And that would be probably enough. Yeah, Sterling Grove was the MVP of this one. That was pretty good. All right, match number two against the Oko. Spinner and some enchantments. Yeah, I mean, I guess I probably have to keep this. I mean, this is on the wrong end of like keepable hands, but I think it's still probably like on the line. Like these, both of these find you the combo, so I mean, that has to be okay. Jeskai most likely going to yeah, I'll start with the Sterling Grove. I don't want to get my creatures lightning helixed. Narset, yeah. Sweltering Suns, not what we were hoping to see. Sanctum Weaver. Okay, well, I guess they don't have the Lightning Helixes, they have all the Sweepers instead. I mean, I can put together the Solemnity 9 Lives combo. I don't know if that's actually gonna be enough against Jeskai. I guess we'll see. It's gonna take a while, but Think maybe keeping the Haven in hand. When this leaves play, I lose the game. What can they have? Farewell is one card that people have been playing. Let's start what by just playing Sterling Grove and we'll see what happens. The fairy is okay. Yeah, I guess that's already a win condition. They can ultimate and then always just put the fairy back every turn and then draw it and do it again, and all the while exiling my permanents. So I'm gonna be the first one to run out of cards. Let's see what's in my deck. Yeah, I don't think this combo is really gonna do much. I'll just run out of cards. So what else can I do? Artifact or creature? I mean, presence seems okay. So that I draw some cards, but yeah, I think I'm kind of just dead. Yeah, what I should have done is I should have just sacked this the turn earlier in my upkeep and to find this and then start going off with the enchant, well, going off, then just start drawing some cards with the enchantments. Oh wait, I can't even do that because they have Narset in play. Never mind. Yeah, in that case, I believe I'm actually just kind of drawing dead here. Like we tried with the creatures early, like it didn't work. They just had the sweepers that kept Narset in play, and they already have a Planeswalker, and they're just drawing infinite cards. Yeah, okay, let's just play another game. Yeah, this is not gonna be the matchup you wanna play. I mean, I could have played Wilfwallow Haven and tried to make a token and attack Narset that way, but I mean they have seven cards in hand and the fairy, like they will probably find a way to deal with the 2/2. All right, how about Gruul aggro? Maybe goblins. Maybe is it Phoenix? That would work also. Just to try out that matchup. You go first, and we have Sunbelt Grove and the farmland hand again. These hands are so awkward. I mean, I can't really not keep, but I'm gonna take a look at the mana base and figure out if there are some lands we can just take away from the decks just so we have more lands that are coming into play untapped. What am I more likely to? I guess if I draw a land that this already comes into play untapped, so I should start with this. Well, that's a good sign. And we did draw an untapped land, that's also a good sign. I go Weaver into Presence, then I have three, two, and I float one. But I can only get one color, so I can't cast anything after that. So do I just start with Cytus? Okay. Get some cards and some life. That is Gruul aggro. That is what we were hoping to see. Now let's see if we can actually turn that into an easy W. Yeah, I'm gonna take it slow and I'll play the Weaver and the Authority. I don't think this is the matchup where like going straight up for cards is the absolute necessity. Yeah, they are dead. I'm just gonna gain so much life. Like every haste creature is basically nullified by this. Yeah, if you play against decks like Gruul, then This should be a pretty decent choice. Now you just need to get paired against that all day. I know we have gotten some requests for a lot for some more best of one content, and well, it's obviously relatively easy to mention that in the articles, even if it just I wouldn't really make any changes. I would just submit the same deck in best of one as best of three. The reason why we don't really talk about best of one is that it's just not a it's not a competitive format. It's not that we don't like it or anything. There's nothing wrong with best of one, but I think the format is more made for just having more about fun and just like playing a higher volume of games maybe because the games go faster, or matches rather. It's not exactly a format that you will find big tournaments in, except for the one Mythic Invitational, obviously. That was probably the most money there was ever in a Magic tournament. But yeah, that's the reason why we're not really, generally focusing on best of one. But we will try to bring you some best of one content, like I'm trying to do right now. And we do know it is popular. I don't have to really shock myself, so I'll just start by playing the Authority. I don't even really have to play it on turn one. In a lot of matchups, you would rather save it for later on, where you can, it's a decent play. You can draw a card and gain some extra life with the triggers and everything. But I think playing it here against a deck that starts with Bomak Courier is definitely the right play, because this is exactly what I was afraid of. Okay, Greenland. Kind of want to block this guy, but I don't know if I want to play Destiny Spinner here. If I play Cytis, then I'm just. No, you know what? I'll play the Spinner. I don't really want to give them free triggers from Robber of the Rich, and if they play a burn spell, they would have played the burn spell on this too, so it doesn't really matter, and this can stop the robber. I didn't really need to start drawing cards necessarily from turn three. Or Chafer Kenra. It does work. It does work. Wow, the one of Authority is doing some serious work in this game. Fervent Champion. Okay, so I'll be taking a couple points of damage. Hopefully they didn't reveal anything too crazy with the robber. Jukai Naturalist. Oh, that's okay. Could have been worse. Okay, so is it Weaver time? I can also play Touch the Spirit Realm, deal with the robber, and that way they can't really do much to me. I can also deal with the Bomak Rear. That would actually be better. How can I lose? Embercleave is a card that can kill me. Bomak Rear, giving them four cards, is definitely a way to lose. So I can just play a land, play this, save three enchantments in my hand. Next turn I can play Cytis into Weaver. Sure. It's kind of strange in this deck that you want to play Weaver as soon as possible so you can start getting mana, but at the same time you also want to save it so you can start drawing cards from the triggers. That's a little strange. But I mean, it's a good problem to have, I guess. Okay, so if I block, we trade, but that's okay. I'm happy to trade for the robber. Could also block the Fervent Champion, but then they just play both of those cards. Yeah, I'll just block the robber. They can pump, we trade, I take what, five? Ooh, okay, they actually have the Embercleave. Well. Time for some nine lives action. Oh wait, this comes to play tapped. Oh my god, no way! That comes to play tapped. I don't have a. Oh wow, I need to check the mana base because this land has been so bad so far. Well, that sucks. Well, I'm dead, right? Yeah, I'm dead. 11, wait, 8, 13, yeah, I'm dead. So I could have shocked myself. I'd be at 10, play this and Weaver. I'm at 11, and then this can block. Yeah. Wow, that's rough. Wow, can you believe it that we're gonna lose against a mono red deck that started with me playing Authority of the Consoles, and I'm eventually gonna lose to Cleave anyways? 9 life, that's what I needed to draw. I think I would have maybe had an act. Yeah, if I played correctly, I'm at 11, 8, 11. So I guess I have to block both. Yeah, I'm screwed regardless, but. So what are my chances? I have to draw 9 lives myself. So I just block the Fervent Champion, make them pump, take 11, go to 1, hope that I draw 9 lives, and then I draw Solemnity. Pretty much what I have to do. So we were 1 card off because they got the 9 lives instead of me. Yeah, wow, what a game. What a game. Maybe a more experienced player with this deck would have just, I don't know, kept the Touch the Spirit Realm in hand for longer, like realizing maybe like Embercleave is the only way I can lose. Like maybe I just don't care if they draw a bunch of cards with the BOMAG Courier. But at the same time, like I'm also not really like too far ahead or anything. Like I still need to draw some cards. Like I need to buy myself as much time as possible, and denying them 4 cards, like that sounds pretty reasonable to me. 9 lives, farmland. Yeah, that sounds good. Yeah, this you can basically never play turn one. Maybe you don't even want to, but the way the mana works in this deck is just not very good. Sulfur Falls. I'll play Aegon Joe, I think. Before deciding what to do with the pathway. Dragon's Fire, interesting. Okay, so now that goes in green. Sanctum Weaver. Okay, that works. Oh, that's such a good feeling. A blue deck passes with mana untapped. Oh, I should have started on Paladin class. That's better because maybe they have not Kolaghan's command, the other command, the blue red command for 3 mana. And if I play Paladin's class first, then they are not going to be able to do that. That's the card I'm talking about. Sterling Grove. Okay. That's the combo. I wanted to give myself more information, like more cards, but I'm gonna be playing the Paladin's class anyway. What deck are they playing? Like, are they just gonna play Goldspin Dragon next turn, or what's going on? Did I already play Nine Lives? I mean, I guess. Oh, they do have counters. Well, then Destiny Spinner is going to be how we force that through. Are they going to play like Lotus Field or something? Or what is this deck? Keeping the spinner in hand as a way to like play it and then try to resolve something that I want to resolve. If I just play it right now, they can play something like a Sweltering Suns or just deal with it. I could find Solemnity and try to resolve that next turn. I don't know if I really need to do that. Probably not. Champion's Presence. I'll play this first. White, green, green. Okay. I think I still want to keep it until I draw the Solemnity. This draws me a card. There's the Sweltering Suns. Yeah, I'll use that on the forest. Turns out that if you're playing against a blue deck and you untap with Enchantress Presence in play, you don't really need to do much else other than just cast random enchantments from your hand. I think, if I remember correctly, one of my first world tournaments was in 2006 in New York. And I think I played against Gabe Walls on some like Legacy Enchanters deck. It was the kind of tournament where you play six rounds in each format every day. So day one was standard. The one with Moldrifter, I think Yuri Peleg won. Oh, that was the one with like Nassif and Chapin having that interesting Dragonstorm mirror. And one of the formats was Legacy, and I played some blue white control, and I didn't really play Legacy before, and my result from the five rounds was with blue white control, with a bunch of standstills and force of wills, was two draws, two wins, and a loss. I think one of the matchups was against an Enchantress deck. I don't know if that's a Legacy thing or if that was a thing from the past 15 years ago, but that's what I just remembered. Do I keep this? Like, this hand's so bad. But I have, yeah, you know what? I'm going to keep it just because I have Solemnity and this deck is. Do I even play this turn one? Like, don't I just want to keep this in my hand if I draw more like Enchanter's Presences? I guess in this format you just keep. What is happening? All right, I'll give it one more game. Can they just not beat a 2-3 and an enchantment that currently does nothing? Yeah, that's a decent hand. Again, I have Paladin's Glass, and I have no idea why that card's in my deck. Yeah, what would I do for a Legion's Landing now? Like, that would actually be a pretty relevant card. I'm gonna keep that in hand, because that's gonna gain me some life later on, draw some extra cards. Robber of the Rich. There it is. Don't take my solemnity, please. Spinner, you can have that. You can have that one. So if I go for Weaver and next turn I play Cytus first, then I get two mana. I have a third one in play. Yeah, I think this is going to be more about speed rather than try to get even more cards from my triggers. I'm fully expecting this to die, but maybe they play a Bone Crusher Giant as a 4-3 or something. Haste is okay. Do I even block? I think I do block. There's not a lot of stuff that does only one damage. Like if they have cards like, you know, Bone Crusher Giant, Play with Fire, whatever, then all of that does. Chain Whirler, they can play. Yeah, I'm gonna block. I guess Spikefield Hazard would be a card that they could perhaps have as a one-off or something. Okay, so let's try to win now. I can probably sit this. This is gonna be on white. I can play Cytus, Paladin class, and then play 9 lives? Let me see, and next turn, Sterling Grove, and then trigger, play something. Okay. It's unlikely that I die. Yeah, I'm afraid of dying. I'm just gonna play 9 lives here. I don't know if that's right, but okay, can I win now? Sterling Grove, that draws me a card. That gets 5 mana. I search for Solemnity, play a land. That's. I think we should be fine. So I sag this. First I get 5 mana, 6, 7. 6, yeah, we should be fine. All white. Sacrifice the Sterling Grove. Put Solemnity on top. Play basically anything. Play Solemnity and win. Oh yeah, I could have played this as well. Well, good luck trying to beat the infinite combo. Oh, I guess they can put the infinite combo together against me as well. Sure, I'll trade them off. I don't want them to get infinite triggers from the robbers and just eventually let me, you know, without win conditions or something like that. I should be careful with the triggers. Like, I don't want to run out of cards either. Destiny Spinner, I need that one myself. Yeah, I don't think I'm playing the presence. I don't think I need that many cards. This deals with the robber. Four, five, six, seven, 8 mana. 3 cards. I can also activate this twice and eventually start attacking, but I don't think I need to do that anytime soon. Wait, I need to discard 5 cards? Isn't that a little... Oh, you need to discard 2. Okay, I was thinking, why is it too many? Why is it so many? Okay. So basically, I need to find Destiny Spinner myself so I can start attacking with a land that's going to be insanely huge and they eventually run out of cards to block with. Maybe even just attacking with one creature with double strike would be kind of okay against them. I also have man land, so yeah, I shouldn't run out of cards or anything. Yeah, well, that's green white Enchantress. It's still in my doubts, still, you know, just putting the combo together just doesn't really feel like back in the days when you played Illusions and Donate. You would just be like, yeah, all right, like I actually just win and there's not that many cards in the format that, you know, gain you 3 life or something, so you go above 20. Now, if you put the 9 life Solemnity together, you're like, yeah, I hope you don't have, you know, Cauldron Familiar or like one of the 17 different cards that people play in the format very often that kills you. But I mean, it worked out fine. We played some nice games, and if you like different decks, I can definitely recommend giving it a try. Thanks to channelfireball.com for sponsoring the video, the Channel Fireball Marketplace, Ultimate Guard for sponsoring us, the Untapped GG app that you should also give a try. And yeah, thanks for watching and good luck in the Arena Open, and I'll see you next time.